Hey, I'm Lo, and welcome back to Legend of Mana. It's been a little while for me. If you're watching this as these videos are coming out, there's been like a week or two long gap. But never mind. Hey, when last we left our hero, we... what did we do? We went to Gem, or Geo, the city of Geo, right? And we solved the wizard kid's problem. and Gilbert was also there, and he was trying to get it on with the basilisk lady, and she didn't seem too into it. I think that was about it, actually, right? Hey! Oh, whoa, huh? My broom? Oh, cutscene. It's gone! My broom's gone! Daddy's broom! No, bud! Gone!
Gone? I bet you just misplaced it.
I don't think so.
Oh wait, wow man, I'm not gonna remember any of the voices that I gave these characters, but I think she had like more of a doll voice, right?
I don't think so. How could I lose such a big old broom like that?
Come on, Lisa. That broom is a memento of Dad.
Oh, it's Cacto. He was gone. I'd forgotten he was gone. He's just swaddling in. Oh.
That the cactus walks.
Ellipses.
What? Are they like laughing? Or crying?
I can't cast spells anymore.
Oh, they're crying. Oh no. Oh, wait, okay, so cactus? Well, I was about to go to Gem or Geo, but now we got this thing, I guess.
Throw away old broom, junkyard.
Talk to him.
He got hard?
Oh, this is... this is reporting on the last quest.
Ew.
Talk to him.
Ew.
Okay. Okay, so the broom is in the junkyard, and the cactus got rid of it. Okay.
Lisa ran away. She overheard what the cactus said. We gotta go after her. Come on.
Nah. Sure, okay, let's go. Oops, wrong way. yeah, like I said, it's been a couple weeks since I played this, and I've been playing some other games in my off time, so there's a good chance that I've completely forgotten the controls for this. Also, I had, again, this is like, I don't know, inside information or whatever. I've just been super busy with, you know, family. It's been like Easter time for me, and also, what else was it? Oh yeah, my computer broke. my whole recording setup was like thrown to the wind for like a week whilst I was fixing my computer. So yeah. Anyway, I managed to save all of the like what they called, I don't know, like user settings or whatever. So once I got everything back up and running, it was actually pretty easy to just like reinstall all my programs and get everything working again. So yeah, that's good. I don't know where the hell I'm going. Isn't this place a horrible maze? let's see. There's... yeah, okay, Bud's with us, so Lisa must be around somewhere. Ooh, a hole. No. Wait. Oh god, okay. Whoa, what are you? You look like a horrible sludge monster. I'm kind of stuck on you. There we go. Okay. Yeah, so... got to, like, reinstall Windows and... spent several days just, you know, like, re-logging into everything. You got stinky breath! Jeez, you don't need to be rude, treasure chest. yeah, this is a whole ass maze, isn't it? Okay. Oh, gosh. Oh, wait, don't these things talk to us?
Of course, the enemy was strong, but I didn't think I would lose. So I wonder, why am I here now?
I think these are the same things they were saying, like... oh no, wait, yeah.
I saw a weird creature carrying a broom bigger than itself. It was green and covered in spiny bits.
Okay, so these aren't the same then. Okay. I think we've gone around in a circle.
I saw a thorny thing with a broom heading deep into the junkyard. Someone cried, help me, but I just ignored him. It was war. That's what I tell myself.
Yeah, so the junkyard's like 100% like a haunted graveyard, right? It's like... like, there's no subtlety here.
not that way. How many lies does that make now?
So it is this way? Fork at the garbage. Did we come this way before? I genuinely can't remember.
Hey. Our friends died one after the other on the battlefield. Everyone here went through that. That's why I'm...
oh.
Go away. We're not on display. We went through so much together.
I wouldn't come any closer. If they see you talking to me, they'll probably laugh at you too.
oh, okay. Stay there. Oh. What if I back off?
Well, I'll take you back to the entrance.
Oh, fuck. No, no, please don't do that. Come on. Hey, you.
Psychotechnic teleport service. All I charge is love.
Bombs laboratory? What the fuck? Hey, dude. Oh man, what does this guy sound like?
I'm Professor Bomb. All the junk lying around here is the remnants of artifact creatures. They fought in a war a long time ago. Once I made a golem out of this trash, but you know what? He ran away. When I think of all the bad things he must be doing out there, it makes me want to cry. I guess I have lapses of judgment now and again.
Oh, I think he did a little cutscene thing, but I couldn't see him.
I named him Pavlov, you see. If you could find him somehow, I'd be so happy.
I'll find him.
You will? Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Professor Bomb's lab. Okay. Can I go in here? Nope.
I heard there's a fortune teller in Domina. Maybe it'd help to get your fortune told.
Oh, I love that voice. I don't know where that came from, but I'm really happy with it. You get a little eye. Nice. Thank you, chest.
Of course, the enemy was strong, but I didn't think I would lose. So I wonder, why am I here now?
Okay, yeah, wait. Didn't we see that one before? Yeah, okay, yeah. I really should have pulled up the website with the maps and stuff that I mentioned a few episodes ago, because this place is so confusing. Oh, excuse me. Oh, sorry. Normally I try and mute when I cough or sneeze. Couldn't catch it in time that time. Sorry about that. Oh, that log looks kind of out of place. Does it? No. Never mind. Yeah, maybe I should pull up that website again.
Oh!
What was this place called? Hang on. Acropolis of Trash, Louis's place. Well, hold on there just a moment, Louis. I'm just gonna steal your shit. I got a wad of wool and an electricity. Oh, no. It's an electricity. Is it? Wait, how do you spell electricity? Oh, man, I'm so dumb. I genuinely can't tell if that's a pun or if that's actually how you spell electricity. Hey, Louis. What do you sound like? Run-on sentences. Is that like he speaks really fast or like really stilted?
The garbage here does not think highly of humans. We must all learn to let love into our hearts. But there is one big difference between the living and the unliving. One can love and one cannot. The garbage here does not... Okay.
Huh. One can love and one cannot. May as well save whilst we're here. You can see how long it's been since I last played. Almost a month. Jeez. Right. Okay. Yeah, so... We tried up, didn't we? You're the teleport back. This way? I feel like we've been here. Have we? Yeah, no, we've definitely been here. Okay. And this way... Up here. I mean, this looks like it goes underground, but then we're just here. And I'm pretty sure this is the same... Or, like, this leads back... to... here. Yeah, so then we can just go down again, and we're back here. Okay. So, where have we not tried? This one? This way?
I'd be happier dying on the battlefield than sitting here, rotting from the wind and rain.
Yeah, the music for this level is just so inappropriate. What's this song called again? Luan Highway, I think, right? Oh, well. I feel like there should be some spooky music playing here, you know? Is this the right way? Ooh, look at that samurai helmet. Oh, actually, some of these are really cute now that I'm looking at them. Yeah. Oh, there's like a soldier guy up there wearing a helmet. Oh, actually, I guess the samurai is also a soldier, right? Technically. Yeah, there's some sort of indicator. Yeah, there's like lots of skulls and stuff as well. Gosh, it's like... Yeah. like this one here, just above me, where I'm standing right now, like little bean wearing an army helmet, like, or this pumpkin down here wearing a pink helmet with a horn on it, like, yeah, this is not subtle, but it's kind of fun. I don't know. It's almost like, I mean, I guess I don't really know how old my character is. Oh, actually, no, it wouldn't be that. I was about to say, like, maybe it's my character is just, like, this is their, like, hallucination of a horrible battlefield or something. Like, they're blocking it out and filling in all of the horrible stuff with just toys and trash. But actually, that doesn't make sense, because we went to the underworld, we've seen dead people, it's... yeah. We've killed so many already. Oh, man. Hang on, what did you say? No, not you. This one, right? You saw the creature carrying a broom covered in spiny bits. One of the other ones said it went to the deepest part of the trash heap. Professor Bond's lab. Can't go in here. Also, is he a bomb? Like, it's kind of hard to see him. But he does kind of look like a bomb. Like, from Final Fantasy. Except he's got little arms and legs. Right? Like, bombs are sort of floating, living fireballs in Final Fantasy. Yeah, I don't know. Was it you?
Hey, look here, not there, here, the wound. This is what keeps me going.
Oh, the pain. Winning, losing, and then winning again. All we could do was fight. It hurts, it hurts.
Jeez. Yeah, okay, I don't think we've met these ones yet, then.
That was scary. I saw a cactus swinging a heavy broom around and mumbling gibberish. It sounded like Leeser, Leeser.
Okay, does that mean we're getting closer? Not that way. How many lies does this make? Oh, okay. This way? No, we've been here. So where? Which way have we not been? Down? Yeah, maybe down here.
Does this look familiar? I'm not sure.
Maybe? Yeah, we're back at the start. God damn it. I'll give it like 2 more minutes, and if I still can't figure it out, then I might just leave. Leeser will be lost in here forever. Or maybe I'm not, like, fulfilling the conditions or something yet. I don't know. Yeah, read that one. Saw a thorny thing deep in the junkyard. Exit to world map. Okay. Yeah, let's just leave it then. That's unfortunate. So. Oops, sorry. Right, yeah, so I think I want to go to Geo again, right? Geo, yeah. And if there's nothing to do in Geo, we can go back to Domina, I guess, and talk to the fortune teller. Oh. Oh no! Gilbert! Gilbert's turned to stone! Oh, you poor fool. Oh dear. Hey, lady.
My fiance is teaching today.
I don't feel like I belong anywhere.
How you doing, Saffron?
I don't know. No school today.
How you doing, Clove? Why are you asking me?
Oh man, was this kid like... Was Bud like... knocked... like, I don't know, is he an alumni? Or did he like... get bullied out of the school?
How you doing? You know, every bartender has a barrel in his soul. I guess you have to be a bartender to understand.
Okay. Nope, okay. Yeah, I guess that my call was wrong then. I was sort of expecting the kids to be all in school now. And for, like, some other citizens to show up.
The wind blew some leaves away.
Ah, that's good air. I should dream well tonight. How you doing, Time? Hey, bud. Are you having good dreams?
Okay. Yeah, I mean, like, he seems to know everyone. That's kind of sweet.
I like to take it easy on my days off.
How you doing, Mace?
Doing?
That guy got held back a few years, clearly.
No school today!
What's up, Oregano? Your dad was a school dropout, wasn't he? Better than your dad.
Oh, this was the... Dagon, wasn't this the kid whose dad died? Jeez, bud. hey, Tipo.
Oh, I'm silly. The bit rules I've mined around here.
No, thanks. You're not the same Tipo, but... it's funny all the same to give him this stupid accent.
Please step up to the counter, please.
so stupid. Hey. Oh yeah, you. Okay. Hey, yeah.
What can I do for you?
Nothing actually, I think. Sandra, right? No. Alex? Kinda looks a lot like Sandra though. Pretty sure they're either the same person or like twins or something. Yeah, okay. Maybe there's nothing here.
Yeah, it's good to rest my weary bones sometimes.
Why? Wait, yeah, you are old people. What?
Why, it's Grandpa Sage. Why, hello, Grandpa Bud. How are things? Wow, Sage, you sure have perfected your grandpa speak.
Oh, wait, are they doing, like... Am I supposed to be doing, like, old voices for them, but, like, fake old voices?
That's right, Sonny. At school, I'm the king of old-timer talk.
Whatever you say.
When I was young, we didn't talk like that to our elders, Sonny.
All right. Yeah, I think maybe they're like kids doing old people voices.
I like school.
Still standing, Brownie?
That's right.
All right, cool. Oh, wait, they said, the Basilisk lady, she said, what's-his-name is teaching today, right? Can we sit in on a lesson?
We could conduct an experiment if Nunu Zack wasn't here.
I love holidays.
How you doing, KN?
Not so good.
Green Wiggly. How you doing, Rosemary? Hey, the Green Wiggly sends you messages all the time. I've never been able to understand you.
I am Nunu Zack, conjurer extraordinaire.
I fucking love this character. He looks so cool. Alright. Let's see. Class? Is this the class? Yeah, here's the class. Okay. Do a little lap. So yeah, can we sit in?
Magic is everything! Hello. With magic, it's important to master the basics.
You're doing alright, Cumin? They're all named after, I've just talked to that. They're all named after, like, herbs and spices.
Hey, Bud, you're alive!
Except for Bud, I guess. And Lisa.
Of course. What do you mean, of course? If you don't breathe, you'll die, right?
What?
I was breathing. So, why were you breathing? Because I'll die if I don't breathe. Ah, so you were breathing because you didn't want to die. I bet you were saying, I don't want to die. I gotta breathe. It's... What? I wasn't saying that.
So how come you're alive?
Ah, it's because it's fun, you know, why else? So you were saying, whoa, life's so fun, I gotta breathe! Yeah, that's right, you got a problem with that? give me a break.
Both these characters have the same voice, don't worry about it.
School sucks!
How you doing, Turmeric?
Hey, Bud, are you the greatest sorcerer ever yet?
This is the same guy. Wait, no. Did we speak to you? No.
School's supposed to be fun. How you doing, Dill? How do I look?
I'm sleepy.
Hey, how you doing?
Astragon? Honestly, I had to do a double take that I thought that said estrogen for a second. yes. The herbs and spices in my spice straw. Dill, rosemary, thyme, turmeric, estrogen, cayenne. You know, all of the things that you keep in your spices straw.
Bud, I heard you were doing well these days.
And, one more voice.
This teacher's not so great.
How you doing, Min?
Hey, Bud, you look like you're doing good.
Okay. Can I not, like, sit in on this class? Also, I thought they said it was a holiday. Why is there a class on right now? Oh, whatever. Okay, well, I guess there's nothing to do here either, then. Did we speak to this, what are you called? Sproutling, right?
I'm only thinking about flowers in bloom.
Alright. Yeah, so I actually don't know, partly because I haven't played this for so long now, but also because I just kind of don't remember, like, in general. I don't know how, like, close we got to, or how close we are to, like, coming to the end of the game.
Hi, I'm Christy. I own this palace.
I am the palace steward. You may call me Sotheby.
we've had this conversation, haven't we? Yeah. They don't complain.
Very well.
Yeah, I don't know. Like I don't know how much more game we've got left, because we've almost filled in the whole map, right? I think we've got some dragon quests still to do. Yeah, have we done all the artifacts? I think we've probably done them all. Or if we do have any left, then it's like one or two at most. So yeah, we probably do just need to like keep doing other quests. Oh, you know what it'll probably be? It'll probably be when the mana tree finishes growing, right? Like, probably once the mana tree is finished, then maybe it'll place itself, or we'll get an artifact in our inventory that lets us place it. I have no idea, to be honest. Okay, where are we going? Fortune teller, right? Yeah, if you're still here. Yeah, hello.
Want your fortune told?
Yeah.
That'll be 10 lucra. I'm saving for my retirement, so no less.
Yes.
There she goes. Oh. I can't hide myself, sorry. The one thing that didn't carry over was my hotkeys. So I need to set that back up, but not right now.
It says, a fateful encounter will happen by the lake. Oh, that sounds romantic.
Thank you. Okay, so that's probably where the troll? Was it a troll or a golem? Pavlov, right?
Oh.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah, I remember. I was like, why did the music stop? But I remembered. There's this monkey guy.
My name's Capella. I'm a wandering juggler. He's so cute. Look at him. Hey, watch this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you stopped. Oh, no. No, it's okay. You can play again.
Yep. I'm gonna...
Wait, what? You're just art. What?
That's right. This way.
What? What's happening? Are you okay? Sirs or madam? Friend? Where did you go? What? Oh no! I'm sorry! I didn't mean to interrupt your music. You don't have to vanish into the void. Oh. Also, the pelican gal's gone, right? The male lady. Oh no.
Did you see Diddle? He always goes running off on me. My juggling just won't be the same without his tune. I gotta go look for him. I guess I'll go ask someone.
You can ask me. Hey.
I gotta go look for him.
Oh. I'm a hero. I can help you. In the bar, maybe? Is it because I have someone with me? Surely not. I don't think that's been a problem before, right?
I'm looking for a friend.
Oh, I thought... I completely misread his tone there. I thought Elazul was, like, finally opening up to me and being like, oh, hero, you're... I've always wanted to be your friend. I'm so lonely, please. No, he means he's looking for his friend. Yeah, okay.
I would be grateful, but you should stay away from us, or...
Come on, let's go. Part ways. See you later, bud.
See ya!
Yeah, so... Yeah, so the monkey, Capella, should have been able... If Capella was a companion, he should have been able to just join us.
Hello.
Could I speak to you?
No. Okay.
Sorry, I've like yawned three times in the last few minutes. Hey.
A typical girl's room, don't you think? Don't laugh. My dad picked everything out.
Hey, Dad.
Ah, I do so love the mountains. Let's leave the shop to Tipo for the day and go for a hike. I bet you didn't know Daddy was good at climbing trees, huh, sugar cakes?
Daddy, why don't you take Mommy? I'll watch the shop for you.
Ha ha ha! Ha 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 ha! It's okay, sweetie baby. You shouldn't have to worry about the shop.
Oh my god, let me out. Let me out, for fuck's sake. Ah! Hey, Tipo.
Mark's dream since he was a lad is to go to outer space on a rocket ship. Childish, eh? Rachel's sick of him too.
Wait, Tipo, why do you live here? Are you literally just like the family teapot? No, wait, there's an actual teapot. I just spotted that. Look here, by the sink. There's an actual teapot here. What? I don't understand why you just hang out in this person's house, Tipo.
What?
You can go this way. Wait, did I know that? I feel like I did know that. Yeah, I think I did know that. Okay. Just took me off guard. Okay. Right. I guess let's go to... What's it called? The lake, right? Lake Kilma, was it?
Go look for Pavlov. Oh, I'm yawning again, sorry.
Ugh. Pavlov, right? Was that what it was called? Oh, wait, was that him right there? Hello.
Ha 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 ha.
Okay. Oh, there's a bunch of toys here, dead toys. I can't talk to them though. Are they supposed to be enemies? But are they not like attacking me?
I left Professor to start my own research. I exterminate foolish creatures with golem army.
Oh. Oh, it's a little boss fight. Okay. How do I attack again? I've completely forgotten. Okay, okay, okay. Here we go.
Ow.
Let me heal.
Ow. Fuck.
Heal. Smack you. Smack, smack, smack. Smack, smack, smack. Smack, smack. Oop.
Ow, fuck.
Yeah. At least his beam is basically just a straight line. Okay, okay. Can't aim down or up. Oh god, it is really hard to dodge though, right? think he's almost down. Is he knocked out? Hang on.
Side sweep!
Missed. Come on, really? I was right in front of him. How did that miss? Oh shit, rabbit's dead. Let me heal. Elazul, you good, buddy? I think he's like stuck on a rock or something. Okay, alright, we did it. Cool. We leveled up as well. Sweet. Wait, were we supposed to kill him or send him back? Oh, we could teleport back here. Oh man, how did he sound again?
Take over the world, fiddlesticks!
What?
I'll redesign you!
Did he just fart? Professor Bob's lab, the end. Wow. What a strange little quest. Alright. okay. We're supposed to be looking for Pearl, right? I swear I saw her with Elazul. I swear I saw her on Luan Highway. As much as I don't want to listen to this song again. I really don't like this song. I think it's the worst song on the soundtrack. Oh wait, no, yeah, this is Luan Highway. So what was the song that was playing in the in the junkyard then? They're both pretty bad, to be honest. I mean, not bad, but just like they're good songs taken by themselves, but like, you know, this is like super dramatic and it's like going really fast and hard. Low Canyon? What? Why is this named after me? Huh. Like, oh, whoa, hello. It's you, aren't you in the intro?
Welcome, come closer.
All right. He's got a hand. Whoa.
Hello there, what do you wish to know?
I have many questions for you. I doubt you can answer them all.
But you already know the answers to all your questions.
You're not taking me seriously, are you?
The answer to that question is within you as well.
Fucking Rockbeard over here.
What a waste of time this is.
Time is what you make of it. By the way, Lo, there should be an ancient tree beside your house. He will help you with many things. You're welcome to return anytime. Toodaloo, bye. Bye-bye now. Goodbye.
Okay. Yeah, Low Canyon. Why is this canyon named after me? Huh. Okay. Yeah, I swear we just... Low Canyon again. What the hell? I swear we saw Pearl, like, dancing around on one of these roads at one point. I don't know. Boink. Oh, fuck, I got boinked. I forgot that you boink me. No, I didn't want to get boinked. Damn it. I wanted to leave. Okay. If it was just L lowercase o, I probably wouldn't have caught that that's my name. Because I'm low, and I don't know. Low is like, L-O is like an alternate spelling of... I don't know, it is a real word as well, right? It means like hark or behold. But because it's a capital O, capital L, capital O, which I sort of did by mistake when I was choosing my character's name at the start of the game. Like, that's what's tipping me off to be like, that canyon is named after me specifically, and I have no idea why. Right, tree in my backyard. Also, we still haven't got the workshop, right? I feel like there's still so much of this, despite talking about, like, oh, how much longer until we finish the game. Oh, hello.
Hi! I just built a workshop for making magic instruments that play magic.
Speaking of which, here we go.
It's up the stairs on the right. Our school assignment this week is to make our own instruments. That's why I built a workshop here. Hope you don't mind. My assignment will be done once I get an elemental coin. Can you help me find one?
Sure. Enchanted Instruments 101.
Thanks, you're a lifesaver. You get elemental coins by playing music to an elemental spirit, but they'll only give you one if they like your song. Come on, let's go look for an elemental spirit.
Oh, we're here.
Wow, an elemental spirit. I've never seen any before. Ever. They don't usually come to places where there's so many people. We're super lucky. Let's try to get a coin. Here, use this instrument.
You got the earth drum.
Try playing a song you like. If an elemental likes the groove, it'll come over here. If it doesn't like the tune or you pack away the instruments, it'll disappear. When one gets close enough, try talking to it. If you succeed, you'll get an elemental coin.
His voice is getting, like, progressively more annoying, but, I kind of love it. Let's play a serene tune on the earth drum. Select a part. What? Harmony?
Actually, the more instruments you use, the better the chance that a spirit will come closer. That's why you should use as many as possible. But right now, one is fine.
Choose an instrument. Do they like it?
Jamming good! Hey, that one seems to like it! Find the right time to put away your instrument and talk to the spirit.
Like now?
Now! Talk to it before it disappears! Hurry!
It left some coins. You got Wisp Silver and an achievement called Braving the Elements. You got Wisp Silver. Bye.
Sweet! That's how you get a coin! Actually, I've never seen it happen in real life! I just told you exactly what I was taught. Alright then, you got your coins! Let's go back to the workshop I made!
Whoa! You made a good workshop, dude!
Whoa! Well, I'm done with my assignment. Now you can make your own enchanted instruments. Have fun! Is there anything you want to ask me about?
How do I make instruments?
Instruments are made with primary materials and elemental coins. You make the body of the instrument with a material like Manus Bronze, and then add the coins to enchant it.
The material in the coin you use determines the type of magic. Anything else?
What are the coins for?
Coins are what give instruments their magical effects. An instrument's elemental type is determined by the properties of the material in its coin. Be sure to check whether the coin is gold or silver. This will affect the instrument's power and magic type. Anything else?
Nothing.
See ya! By the way, can I have two of those wisp silvers? I'll trade you three coins I got from my friends.
You got aura silver. You got salamander silver. You got menace bronze.
See ya!
What a weird kid. Enchanted Instruments 101, the end. Nice. Wow. Okay, well, that... Speak of the devil and he shall appear, because I was just saying, hey, what about what happens with the workshop, eh? Well, there we go. That's my answer, right? In here, is it? Oh, fucking hell. Another one.
I built a golem laboratory right here. I'm sure the golems you make won't go on violent killing sprees. I'll give you a guided tour. Walk this way.
Oh, we're just getting all the tutorials with all the characters with the silliest voices right now, huh?
Welcome to the Golem Laboratory. I brought everything you need from my own lab. Let's heat her up. Impressive, eh? But there's still some things missing. I'm talking about life balls and logic blocks, and I won't just give them to you. I'm gonna test you to see if you've got what it takes, kid. I'll be using problems straight from my book, Basic Golemology. Have you read it?
Never heard of it.
Of course you haven't. I haven't published it yet. A while back, a traveling merchant came and begged me to publish it. He made me buy an old pen and some writing paper for a ridiculous amount.
Was that Niccolo by any chance?
So I decided to put my thoughts down. But the merchant never came back for the manuscript. He tricked me. But that book never leaves my side. It's the fruit of my labor after all. Well, here it is. So read up. We'll start the test as soon as you finish.
Oh my fucking god, dude, really? Right now? A golem's composition. What are the necessary components of a golem? A golem completed by body and logic blocks. The body of the golem determines its power level, and the logic blocks provide the techniques for the weapon it uses. What makes up a golem's body? At least one weapon or piece of armor. A golem's body is made by combining a life ball with at least one weapon or piece of armor. You can only use one weapon per golem, but up to three pieces of armor. Its parameters and performance are determined by the properties of the equipment and items used to make it. What makes up a logic block? Two pieces of equipment. Logic blocks are made by combining two pieces of equipment from your list of armor, weapons, and instruments. Each block represents a single technique, and blocks can be rearranged to instruct a golem how to behave. So is this like a way to use up your leftover resources or your like spare unused equipment? Maybe? What determines the size of the logic grid? The number of armor pieces used to make the golem's body. The larger the grid, the more logic blocks it can hold, and the wider variety of actions the golem can perform. What determines a logic block's type? The combination of its components. Experiment with different equipment combinations to create the logic blocks you want and customize your golem's action patterns.
What determines a logic block's shape? God, I really hope this is all leading up to a, like, fake out where it's trying to make it seem really complicated, and then in reality it's actually really simple. Because I don't want to fucking learn this, dude. What determines a logic block's shape? The combination of its components. Logic blocks can have one of 11 shapes, and a block's effectiveness derives from the parameters of the materials used to make it. What determines a golem's attack type? The type of weapon used to make its body. A logic block can be placed on the logic grid if it is compatible with the golem's attack type. Attack and defense levels. What determines a golem's attack and defense levels? The properties of the weapons and armor used to make it. A golem's stats, such as HP, attack, defense, and elemental levels, are determined by the materials used to make its body. Logic grid and size. Logic grid size and malfunction rate are determined by other means. How is the malfunction rate determined? By the number of armor pieces used. The higher the percentage shown on the menu screen, the more frequently the golem's attacks will fail to trigger. If one action fails, actions connected by wedge marks on the body on the logic grid will also fail. How does a golem decide which action to take? By comparing its action gauge with the distance to the enemy. The logic grid has two axes, one for the action gauge, one for the distance to the enemy. The golem calculates these values and decides which actions to take based on the result. Fucking hell, dude. Just stop. No. No, I'm not. Are you ready to begin the test? Fine, I'm ready. Fine, fine. Now for the test. Question. Here's a really basic problem. What do you need to activate a golem?
A body and its logic block.
That's right. Question. Another basic problem. What do you need to build a golem's body?
Weapons or armor.
That's right. Question. Logic blocks can be made from weapons, armor, and what else?
Music instrument.
That's right. Not bad at all. Here's one life ball. Question. What determines the size of a logic grid? The brains of a golem.
The preschool education. The number of armor pieces.
That's right. Question. Logic blocks control golems' behavior, but what determines their type?
Genes. Luckily, these answers are, like, reasonably easy to deduce just based on, like, common sense, I guess. Combination of equipment.
That's right. Not bad at all. Here's another life ball. Question. What equipment properties determine the shape of a logic block?
I'm starting to hate this guy. Their attack and defense, the materials they're made of, Pacific Standard Time. Oh man, I was not expecting a fourth wall break in the middle of this. Oh shit, actually this is, what equipment properties determine the shape of a logic block? The equipment properties, so it's not... Oh fuck, it might be the materials. The shape? Okay, I'm gonna say the materials. That seems more right to me.
That's right! Question! What determines a golem's attack type?
Weapon type?
That's right! Not bad at all! Here's the last life ball! Life balls are globular crystals of pure mana! You can't make a golem's body without one!
And you can't activate a golem without a logic block. Let's get on with the test. Question. A golem's attack power is determined by that of the weapons used to make it. But what determines its defensive strength?
The armor's defensive strength?
That's right! Question. What determines a golem's malfunction rate?
How malfunctions? Number of sorties? Number of armor pieces?
That's right! Question. The vertical axis on the logic board represents the attack gauge. What does the horizontal axis represent?
Love. Distance to enemy. I seem to weirdly remember that.
That's right! Oh my, you passed! I present you with a logic block cauldron. Woohoo! You can make logic blocks by putting weapons, armor, and instruments inside. You can't activate a golem without a logic block, so put the cauldron to good use. I'll give you this as well.
You received basic golemology. Thank fuck.
I'll leave my research to you. But I'll first...
No, please, just leave. Go away.
But first, I'll explain how to actually make a golem here. To make the body, use one of those three life balls on the pedestal there. And use the cauldron to make a logic block. You can also use the cauldron to organize or throw away your blocks. I'm retiring from golemology. From here on, I want you to continue my research. I've had enough of it, and it takes too much cash. You heard me. To create and activate a golem, you need money. To make a body, you need at least one weapon or piece of armor. And you need 12 weapons, pieces of armor, or instruments to make 6 logic blocks. Preparing the materials takes a lot of time and money. I wish you good luck in continuing my research in golemology. Try your best. Making golems is a lot of fun, you know.
And he farted again. Well, you're retiring. Guess what? I'm also retiring. I am never going to touch this mechanic. Please leave.
I'm going home, but I'll help you get started. No, just leave, for fuck's sake. I want you to have this.
You got Menos Bronze and Valsenna Iron and Granz Steel.
Fine. Good luck in your research.
Your line ends here, old man. I am never touching this again. Call 'em, go make 'em. The end. Fuck me. Okay. Oh, I swear to God, if I try and walk into this workshop one more time and I get another tutorial. Maybe I shouldn't, right? Maybe I shouldn't risk it. I just want to... No, yeah, I'm not gonna risk it. I'm not gonna risk it. We're gonna save right here. And next time we will find out whether or not there's yet another tutorial inside this building. Oh man, what a fucking trip. Thank you very much for watching. I've been your host, Lo. This isn't my normal outro. What am I doing? Love and peace.